I think that, like, people look at me and they don't see a typical scientist. And so I want them to know that I'm not. Hi, my name is Bernadette Dineen. I am a graduate student in the Tufts Chemistry Department, where I work in the Kunavis Lab on astrobiological and astrochemical projects. Why did I become a scientist? I think I was born one. I think, honestly, a lot of children are born scientists, and then they kind of maybe drill it out of you. Who knows? I don't think I really decided to become one. I think it picked me. So I ended up going to undergrad at a small liberal arts college for chemistry. If anybody wants to know about whether or not they have to go to a really important undergrad or a really important school or do all of these things, that's not the case. I went to a tiny liberal arts college that a lot of people don't even know about. And I worked hard, I did really well, and then it got me to Tufts. And so here I am. There have been some obstacles. I'm an autistic woman in STEM, and so learning how to navigate interactions with people has been a constant learning experience for me. I'm also like a first generation college student. I'm like the one that got away, like the one that got out, like I broke the wheel. And so it's a really hard to find myself in academic spaces, because the percentage of people in the room who have, say, also been homeless gets lower the higher you go up. Which matters to me, because there's a perspective I think you get in life when you're homeless or when you grow up in extreme poverty or all those other things, that I'm finding the higher I go up in academia or into like study really important things like space, that the communities are different, if that makes sense. I'm not trying to speak ill on it. I'm just saying, like, that's a really big obstacle for me, is not being able to relate to the experiences of everybody. You have to really make yourself hard when you're a woman in STEM. You can't let a lot get to you. You're gonna be called a lot of names a lot of the time. And people aren't gonna take you seriously. So you kind of gotta make yourself really kind of hard-edged. I don't want to sacrifice the soft parts of myself in order to be taken seriously. And I want to make and live in a world where I don't have to do that.